What is happening, guys? Welcome back to the channel and to another video on the Golf. So, in the last one, you saw we repaired a few bits here, repaired the boot floor, and generally did a bit of cutting and tidying up, and ensuring that panels and things were going to fit where we wanted them to. Also made a couple of other panels as well. This episode, we are going to be start fitting these panels, really. So my plan at the moment, I've been round and primed inside this arch on that lip. I've primed, well through primed that, and I've primed the back of this lower corner here as well. We're just really gonna make a start on getting them in. So my plan is gonna be, we'll clamp this inner arch here into place, into the correct place, which will then give us this line that this needs to follow down, because it might mean that we've got to angle it slightly for this and weld this gap up here, but it hopefully should be okay. And then from there, that's then going to probably lead on to clamping a few of the bits up, and then we'll make this a piece at the bottom here to close the end of the sill off. But I suppose it's just going to be, as ever, let's just take it as it comes. First things first, let's get this arch clamped in place, get this clamped in place, and get this bit tacked on. Right, so that's clamped in place. Now this will now allow us to put this so that it's touching this and clamped to that, so we know it's in the right place. So, I'm gonna knock that down a bit. Is going to go somewhere out there. So that's that clamped in place, this part. Before we move anything, everything's touching and everything where it needs to be. I'm gonna get two, maybe three tacks, maybe four tacks on that, just so we know it's not going to move. That is now spot on where we want it. So, letters. So let's get a couple of tacks on that. We'll hopefully get that bit in and run away. So that's tacked in place now. We'll whip this arch out. I can fully weld that piece in then. We'll knock it about a little bit more, get it perfect. But yeah, looking good so far. So there's that bit in now, and all sort of dressed. I'm pretty happy with that, That welder is, I thought it was dialed in before, but it is even better now. We've got nice penetration at the back, It's absolutely solid. Dressed okay. There wasn't enough of a gap. There's a bit of a sort of crown there where it's lifted it a bit, but we'll get away with that. We'll get away with that. So now what we're gonna do is chuck this in our arching. Sitting in the right place again with my marks that are still visible. Like that. Yeah, that is pretty good. A bit of knocking about. Nothing that a bit of hammering won't stop. There's always going to need a little bit more. That's about there. So what we do is now we'll draw a line down there, or we'll just drill this for spot welds. So that's all done. What I've done now is I've clamped all of these panels back on. So the arch is on, the inner sill's on, the outer sill's on, because we've now got to address all this issue in this corner. So we've got to close this off and make a piece. So we're going to be cutting this somewhere here. We'll follow this line and then probably bring a round into here and then create a panel to fill that in. We'll weld that back up. These are going to get welded up when the inner sill goes on anyway. So we now need to make a part to finish that off. Now we're going to have to trim this and knock this bit back, I think, to continue the sill on. But we'll do that now, make a piece to finish that off. So there we have another CAD template. Create a little lip up there, we'll weld that too. That there, finish that edge. That is a good basis to make a start. So we'll cut out a steel and then hopefully we'll be able to bend it and sort it all out easy enough to get it in. And then I think that will be the next thing to weld into the car and get back in, get solid. And then this, I think then will be the next part to go in. And there is that piece cut and sort of folded and bent and everything into shape, looking good. It'll close the back edge of this off nicely. We'll weld it all. It's going to be seam sealed anyway. So we'll draw around that now, get it cut out, get that piece all welded in, dressed and done. Get all this line sorted out as well. So then guys, there's that new piece all in. It's overlapping. You can see this little curved bit here. I've bent a bit of metal out of the way. It's sat on there overlapping. What I'll do is send a grinder through both to give us a nice gap. But before I do that, I'll be tacking and welding it in. We can then remove all these other bits. And we'll be able to get that fully welded in. And then hopefully the arch is nice and solid, ready for this outer piece to get plug welded from the back into place. So let's get back on the GoPro and roll with that. And there's that corner piece fixed in, all repaired. So it came, I think it was up here, along over there and into there. So yeah, I think, well, there was nothing there and the other corner was completely rotted away as well. So I had no gauge of what it was supposed to look like, but I think what we've done is right. I might have to put a little infill in where it matches this chassis rail. It comes along the bottom, but it looks much better than it did before. So we've got two options now. We can either put this inner arch back in here and plug weld it from the back, or there's an infill piece that needs making in here when the inner sill goes on. And I'm thinking I might do the bit that goes in there for the inner sill, because then that is sort of plating and me making parts done. So we'll get this rolled over onto its side. We'll get the sill in, get it rolled over, get it all clamped in, roll it over, and then we'll start templating to make this piece and see how we're going to do it. So then, this is the bit I was talking about. So this, on the on a genuine or original sill, this flange that's on this side comes up here and sort of all ties it together. Now the one I've got, or aftermarket, whatever it was, doesn't have that. So we need to close this part of the car off. So what I'm thinking is, I made this, which is just a card template, it's curved. So this is just a card template, it's curved that way, flat piece on there with a bit of a upturn on the end, and I'm thinking we're going to make something that is going to go on there and just basically weld in a bit like that to just close it all off. Or at least that's what I'm thinking at the moment anyway. So I think I'm going to make this in two pieces. So we'll cut down here, because it is two separate pieces anyway. And then we'll get it all together on the bench and weld it on the bench. Then come back and weld it in the car that way. But I want to make it, probably not going to weld it in yet, but I'd like to make it now so that it's done. We may even chuck this in from the underside before the sill goes in. We cut it back somewhere here. We may be able to put this in even before we put the sill in. That might work even better than what we were thinking before. Morning guys, right, so new day. Where did we get to yesterday? So we've got this back corner on and finished. Tied in a bit of the inner arch up. We got this front part of the arch done to a point. And then I made this piece. I posted this on my Instagram last night and asked if anybody knew where it was from, what it was for, where it goes. So this piece is gonna be difficult to show because it's the right paint. But, so it's this area in here. So on in here, you've got the sill. There's a flange that sort of, a lip that goes into there. And on the original car, it goes in and goes all the way up inside there, and there's another lip for you to weld sort of that way. But on this aftermarket one, it sort of feathers out here and just goes into a rolled piece, just there. So this is this flange, and it normally would come and continue and sort of roll up like that, but it doesn't on this aftermarket one. So we need, when we put it in, there's a big gap here that allows it sort of from the inside of the car into the sill. So what I've made is this piece that will slot in somehow in there. It's not going into the right place, but there you go. That slots into there like that. That then finishes, you can see the piece there, but that then finishes this inside piece because you can see where the gap would be. And your sill then runs along the top of it. So what I'm gonna do with this is it's gonna be twisted, so it's gonna be pushed up that way, but pushed down that way, so that this lip goes in between the two, and then we can weld them all together. But what I'm gonna do for this one, push it in as far in as I can, couple of tacks in it, just hold that in place, so it's in the correct place for when we put the sill on. And then everything is where it really needs to be. And I've given it a lick of paint. I've ground some of this back, but this has all got paint behind it. So let's get that little bit tacked in. And then when that is in, we're then gonna probably, I've been saying it quite a few times, I'm gonna chuck this bit in, I think, and then run away. Oh, and if the lighting's a bit better, that's because I've treated myself to two of these sort of photography lights or whatever they are. But I think they're making me look a bit better and everything, so hopefully they'll work. They weren't expensive. So hopefully lighting's a little better now. I've just got more things to move around when I'm moving around the car. So that's that piece welded into place for now. I've then gone over, as you can see, on this bit here and on here, plus all of the sill inside as well. I've gone along everything that is going to be welded or near somewhere that's going to be welded that's got wax oil or anything like in the sills and things on it, and I've cleaned all of that back to either the primer or bare metal, so that when I go welding the sills on, I'm not going to have wax oil or anything falling down into the weld and making a bad weld and making it more difficult to weld. So I need to go over and give all that a blast of primer, which I shall do in a moment. But the next step that I've been going on about for ages is we're gonna weld this outer inner arch in now, finally. So it's in, it's clamped, it is, all the marks are lining up, it's where it wants to be. So I'm gonna roll the car over, probably over 180 degrees, see how that looks, and maybe start welding it in. And that'll be the first.
Is it the first?
Yeah, that's the first Heritage Supply panel that'll be going in the car. Talking of Heritage, thank you so much to those guys for sponsoring the rebuild of this car. Blew me away that they wanted to work with me. If you're doing anything Volkswagen or Porsche related, go on their website, heritageparkcentre.com. We're using the code CHAMBERS at the checkout. We'll get you 10% off your order. Massive thank you to those guys for working with me and for giving you the code as well. Such a nice thing for them to do, to just give something back to you guys. And yeah, you get a bit of a discount as well. So let's roll on with this and get going. There we go, that is that in, welded and sort of dressed to a point. Need a bit of tidying up, but yeah, that's that in and I am pretty happy with it. And here we are from the other side. So we've plug welded these ones from this side as well. You've got a bit of weld, we've got a bit of weld coming through here, which is just because these spot welders were quite close to the edge originally. Obviously the ones I've drilled out, and I drilled them bigger to get them out. But I'm well happy with how that's turned out. It's in, it's where it needs to be. It's solid, it's new, it looks amazing. I'm well happy with that. We're making some pretty good progress now. So I have now started thinking and looking at other things. So I've got this chassis row clamped in. I've removed this, which I think is a jacking lifting point, and the exhaust hanger that I've now got welded on. They need cleaning, tidying and dressing before that section gets put on. Obviously, we've welded that little infill piece in there. Again, needs welding, needs cleaning, needs priming. I have tried the inner sill on just to make sure that I'm happy with how it sits, where it is, everything's in the correct place, get everything pulled. And that looks pretty good. So I'm thinking that is going to be the next thing we're going to put in the car. I've got to rebuild this bit, but I'm figuring it'll be easier when the inner sill's in and in its final position. So next thing's going to be to get the inner sill in and welded into the car. That then leads on to being able to sort out this rear beam mounting, which I've had quite a few messages on, telling me that I shouldn't have cut it and shouldn't have just taken it out of the car. I should have made a jig. Yeah, I know. But hopefully we're going to be able to get it back. If we put the beam on, just rear struts on, we're going to be able to get it straight enough for where it needs to be. So next thing's going to be to chuck the inner sill on, and that'll then move on to the other bit. So not really sure how it's going to work, but let's get rolling on with that. Oh, so on the sill, I've just made a start on that, and the seat belt mounting hole for the passenger side, sort of lower where it bolts into the, obviously into the sill, is ever so slightly out. It's not in the same place as the other side, which means there's a little plate somewhere, I don't know where, there it is. Which means there's a little plate that's, this has come off the old sill, obviously, and I need to fix that where I slipped with a grinder. But that mounts into it somewhere near this end. And where the hole is in the new panel, if you mount it like that, there's not enough room for this to come back down. So we've got to move that back. It isn't a lot, but if you look at this, that's where it's got to go. That is a little round that I've just cut out, which isn't in the right place now because I've just pressed it. That needs clamping in place properly and welding in and dressing. And then this point here is where the new hole has got to be. I've marked that for measuring this one, down there, off the other side. So that'll put that in the right place. So that's the first thing I've got to sort out on that. Then weld the seatbelt bracket to it. So we don't forget that, because we don't want to be forgetting that. So there's the area all cleaned up. I've drilled the new hole because I've had to obviously grind this back. You can still see the scratch, but I thought I'd drill a starter hole for the new hole. This piece is in there now. For some reason it's not quite sitting in flush to the front face, but what I'm going to do is, says, if you can get pick on it, wherever it is, we're going to push it up with this pick as I tack it, just to get it nice and flush to the top, so this face is nice when we dress it. There's that plate then been repaired. There was a slit down there, so we fixed that. And there is that side. Got to sort these holes out, drill these for spot welds. All the back's all zinc primed, so we can weld this on here. Now, I've been and dug out the original bolt that holds it on, the seat belt in. So we'll put that in to clamp that part in place to weld it together. So what I'm going to do first is I'm just going to chuck it in the car and make sure it's where I want it to be. It should be, because I measured it. I have been wrong once before. That fits spot on, so we can now get it welded up. There we go, seatbelt mounting in. So there's that sill all prepped. It's been sanded, all the black paint's been sanded back in the areas where it's going to be welded. It's had weld through primer put on it, and I've gone along and put some holes in it for where we're going to spot weld it. I've also put holes in the car where I've needed to, but where we've drilled the spot welds out is what we're going to fill back in with the weld. So something I bought is this, called a joggler. So this has got these clamps here. I clamp a piece of steel down and create like a step in the piece of steel. I did have a bit, but I don't know where it's gone. So you can then push them together, seam weld it, and you've got a nice strong welded joint. This side also clamps down. It wasn't those ones. It was those ones, and it clamps down and puts a perfect hole for welding. I think it's like 4.8mm or something, and they are a dream to weld once you've got it set right. So, that panel's prepared. The car is now all primed, prepared, and ready for us to then put this panel in. So let's get this in, get it all clamped in place, and then we'll start welding it. And there is that inner sill welded in to the car. Now, obviously, it all needs dressing still. It's not finished, but that's that welded in. It's where it needs to be. It took a bit of manipulating to get things into the sort of right place, but it's in, it's solid. This isn't welded yet because we've got to fix that and sort it out. And I've not fixed this lower corner here. These cable ties were, I had a ratchet strap to the that tube that was pulling this floor away because the floor was putting pressure on the sill and not allowing me to get the sill into the correct place. So I just pulled the floor up a bit, or the seat, to get it out of the way. But yeah, we've got to fix obviously all this lower, rebuild this corner where this all ties in. But I figured that'd be easier when this sill was in the car and we've got a positive location for it all to mount to. So looking at it from this side, this is all welded in and all the way along here, looking pretty good. So any other plug welding I've done and on the other car in other areas, sort of, there's only been little bits, but there have been bits I've done. They haven't really gone very well. But these, I think have gone pretty well. It's all stuck nicely. And yeah, everything is, there's nice penetration coming through the back. It's solid. They might have built up a little bit too much, but I'd rather be able to grind it back than not have welded it properly. So yeah, super happy with how that's gone. It's nice and solid, it's in the right place. So I've obviously still got quite a lot of panels still to fit to the car, but this is a good start. I'm pretty happy with the way it's gone. I was worried about getting this inner sill back in because it is sort of a quite an important part of the car and it's got to go in the right place, but it's in. I'm happy with how it's gone. Get all this dressed up and hopefully it will look nice and neat. First two pieces that have been supplied by Heritage that have gone into the car, which is amazing. So thank you to those guys for supplying the panels and for sponsoring this build. So in the last video, I mentioned that I'd bought weld through primer. Yeah, don't buy that. It's no good at all. It isn't weld through. The welder, when you're welding it, it sort of spits and spatters and it builds up balls on the surface of it that then sort of jump off or get pushed off of it, hit the floor, explode and go everywhere. Don't use that at all. This stuff, which is a U-Pole weld through primer, is brilliant. It is night and day compared to the Halfords rubbish that I was using. So yeah, don't buy Halford stuff. Spend the money on some proper stuff. I mean, the Halford stuff looks like just normal grey primer. It doesn't look anything special at all. This comes out and it looks like silver paint because it's got, I imagine, zinc and bits in the paint to help the weld get through. So yeah, spend your money on some decent stuff. So massive thank you again to Sealy Tools for helping along with some tooling for the build and for the workshop. Some real good tools at some great prices. If you've not already, have a look on their website and also go and follow them on Instagram. I'll put a link to both in the description. I'll also put links into the description of a few of the tools I've used throughout this video. So I just want to say a massive, massive thank you to every single one of you that subscribes to the channel, likes the videos, comments on the videos. It really does mean so much. We are still chasing the 20,000 subscriber mark by Christmas. We've got 5 weeks left to go. Every single one of your interactions helps with getting us out there onto the recommended page of people that might not know about us and may have not already seen some of my videos. If you don't already, do please consider subscribing and help me get to that 20,000 mark by Christmas. Do please continue to like and comment on the videos as well. As I said, it all really helps within YouTube's algorithm of getting us out there to a wider audience. So hopefully you've enjoyed it. I've enjoyed this one. I really feel like I'm making a bit of progress now. Fitting panels that have been pressed and supplied instead of me making bits of metal feels like quite a big achievement, quite a big milestone in the build. Not sure how long this side's going to take us to get back to solid again, but hopefully, having done what we've done, we are just getting ever closer every day. So we'll leave that one there, guys. Thank you all so, so much for watching. I do really, really appreciate it. From me in the seesaw of a car, until next time, enjoy.